Hi, hello, and how do you do? We all welcome you. This is where we sing and play and learn new things each day. Hi, hello.
Hi, my dear students. Welcome back to our educational channel. Dear students, in the previous class, we have been discussing our third lesson, that is called the golden touch. In this video, we are going to study about reading last five paragraphs, new words and explanation and last theme of the lesson. So this is the third part of the lesson, and also we will conclude this lesson in this video. Now I am going to ask a few questions which are related to the previous paragraphs. So here your first question: who was Dionysus? It's a very easy question. Dionysus was a god, isn't it? God Dionysus has given a wish to King Midas. Which wish? The golden touch, isn't it? Next question: what was the name of the daughter of King Midas? Very easy. Mary Gold. The name of the daughter of King Midas was Mary Gold. And next one question: what kind of person was King Midas as a father? Yes, as a father, he was loving and loved his daughter dearly. Zin. So with this, let us move on today's paragraphs. So before that, here you can see meaning of new words. Take the screenshot and write it down in your English notebook, and also question answer you should be write in your English notebook. Is it clear? So in the previous class, we discussed that King Midas got a wish. King Midas has got a wish, the golden touch, and he has touched everything to become gold, beautiful yellow gold. Then he wanted to celebrate his new fortune. So then he sat down in the dining hall. He wanted to eat bread, whichever eatable things, those all become gold. Then he was ground means shouted with painfully. Then he left the huge dining hall. I'm going. Just then his little daughter came running into the room, and he could realize his wish. She already in his arms. Who? His daughter. So now what happened next? Let's see. Here you can see today's paragraphs. Let us start reading today's paragraphs. Put your finger and listen carefully. Tears streamed down his face as he felt the apple of his eye stiffen into a cold, golden statue. So here streamed down means to flow down, to flowing, and stiffen means unable to move. It become statue, golden statue. Who? Marigold. So here, when he saw the apple of his eye, it means to be grateful, loved by someone. It is a idiomatic phrase. The apple of his eye means who is here? Marigold. So who is the apple of his eye? Marigold means loved someone. It means loved someone dearly. That is she, Marigold. So tears streamed down. Who? King Midas, flowing down his tears. Flowing down his tears. Why? When she is in arm and she is become lifeless figure, golden statue. Why? Because she hugged him and she become statue, golden statue. So he was very sad and was feeling very bad himself because of that wish she has become golden statue. See, so he was become very sad. He streamed down his face. His tears streamed down his face as he felt that the apple of his eye means Marigold, his daughter, stiffened into a cold golden statue. Next, he left his palace and his garden. Weeping bitterly, he prayed for Dionysus to appear before him. Miserable, Midas threw himself at Dionysus' feet and begged him to undo the magic. So he was feeling very bad himself about that wish. He was regretting. So that time he left her in the palace and he left the palace and garden, went out and standing on the hill. He was going very far and he was praying. Weeping bitter means crying very bad. Crying very bad. He prayed for the Dionysus to appear before him. Means appear means visible in front of him. He was pleading, he was begging, prayed. Please God, help me. Please visible in front of him. Miserable Midas means very unhappy. He was very unhappy. Midas threw himself at Dionysus' feet. So when the god Dionysus appeared visible in front of him, very unhappily, he threw himself at Dionysus' feet. He bent down himself and begged him. He bent down Dionysus' feet at Dionysus' feet and begged him to undo the magic. So he is begging. He was begging to the god Dionysus, please God, undo the magic. Which magic? Wish. The golden touch wish. Undo that wish. Then god Dionysus asked, are you sure you no longer wish to have the golden touch? So god Dionysus asked him, when he begged, when the king Midas begged him, once again he asked, God Dionysus asked him, are you sure? Are you sure? You are sure? You are sure to no longer wish? You no longer wish to have? You don't have longer the golden touch wish? Then King Midas said that, no, I have learned my lesson. I no longer think gold is the greatest thing in the world. King Midas wept and kept on pleading with Dionysus. So God Dionysus asked him, are you sure I should take back that magic? I should take that, or I should undo the wish? You don't want that wish no longer? So then King Midas wept and kept on pleading with Dionysus. Means he begging, he was regretting himself and pleading to the God Dionysus. Pleading means requesting. No, God Dionysus, I don't want that wish. Because you before warned me that risk. You said me that risk, about that risk, about the wish. So I have learned my lesson now. Now I have learned my lesson. I never think that gold is the greatest thing in the world. I have learned the lesson. Gold is not the greatest thing in the world. Yes, my Lord, I learned my lesson. Please forgive me. So he begged to the Dionysus. Then finally, relenting, Dionysus said, go and have a bath in the water of the river Pactolus. You will become normal again. Then sprinkle some of that water on everything that had transformed into gold. So finally, relenting means to become less severe. So without further delay, with very bad of King Midas, without further delay, suddenly he has given the solution. Who? God Dionysus had given solution to the king. That is, go and have a bath in the water of that river. Which river? Pactolus. You will become normal again. So then that water sprinkle on everything that which things you have touched, you sprinkle some of that water on that everything. Is it? So then the king rushed to the river and hurriedly had a bath, filling a pitcher with the water from that river. He sprinkled it on Marigold first. Instantly, she returned to her normal human self and gave him a kiss. The king then went around the palace, sprinkling water on everything he had touched. Then he and Marigold sat down for a delicious breakfast. So when the god Dionysus had given solution to the king Midas, the king rushed out means ran quickly to the river and hurriedly had a bath and filled a pitcher. Pitcher means here large jug. Here you can see the pitcher. This is pitcher means jug, a larger jug. Large jug. He filled the pitcher with the water from that river. Which river? Pactolus. River Pactolus. He sprinkled that water on Marigold. Firstly, he sprinkled the water on Marigold. So immediately she returned to her normal human being and gave him a kiss. Then she gave his father a kiss with lovingly, and the king then went around the palace sprinkling water on everything which he had touched. So he went around the palace remembering that those things which he had touched. So then he and Marigold sat down for a delicious breakfast. So when he sprinkled the water on everything which he had touched, those all things became normal. So then he was relaxed and sat to have a delicious breakfast. So food had never tasted so good before. So here, which moral we learned here as given. So food had never tasted so good before. So in front of the food we can keep very expensive things that is not tasted, that is never tasted than food. So here there is nothing else important and better than food. Is it? So this is complete explanation about this lesson. So we have completed in this video. Now I'm going to explain briefly by showing the picture. Look at the picture. So when he realized, before he realized she was in his arm, and his tears flowing down his face because the apple of his eye, means Marigold, become golden statue. Then he left the palace and garden weeping bitterly. He prayed to the god, and god Dionysus appeared in front of him, and he bent down and begged him to undo the magic. So then Dionysus asked him, and then he said that he regretted, and he said that I have learned my lesson, that is gold is not greatest thing in the world, please undo this magic. Then he, without further delay, god Dionysus has given the solution, that was to have a bath in the river Pactolus and sprinkle that water on everything which you have touched. So then he went to the river. Look at that, and picture means that is large jug. He filled that large jug and sprinkled on marigold first. She become normal again and she hugged him, and then he went around the palace, sprinkled the water and on everything which he had touched. Then he relaxed and he sat down to have a delicious breakfast. So food had never tasted so good before. So there is nothing else important and good, better than food. If you kept in front of you so very expensive things that is never tasted than food. Is it clear? So now, what did we learn from this lesson? What is the theme? Look at here. Gold is not the greatest thing in the world, is it? And next, there is nothing important and better than food, is it? Hope you understood and you learned these lessons, is it? From this lesson, is it clear, student? Okay, now take down the homework. Write the meaning of new words and question answer in English notebook one time, and read the whole lesson two times. It make it yes here two times. Is it clear? Now, so we will back with a new lesson in the next video. Till then, goodbye. Thank you, my dear students.